Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening and welcome to the Night Concert Hall at the Adrian Arsh Center and to Piano Slam 11. It is so fantastic to be back in this hall. It's so beautiful, and it's great to see all of you here. You know, tonight's Piano Slam is very, very, very special, because tonight's Piano Slam is all about who we are as music, who we are in the relationship to our waters and our ocean that's around us, and who we are when we live right here in Miami-Dade County. So, yeah, this is home, everybody, Miami. You know, we don't think about that this often, and we have so many young people here tonight. But one of the things that's really important to think about from time to time is what a young city we are and how far we have come in just over 100 years. But what is also so special about Miami-Dade County, and so special about the time we live in, whether you're here with a school or whether you're here with your family or whether you've been a patron of this hall since it's broke ground or whether you've been here since a long, long, long time as a native in Miami as I am. We're so fortunate, being a young city, to know some of our founders. Some of our founders who brought us the Miami that we know today, the music that we know today, and really art and culture today, are still here and are still really making this city beautiful, wonderful, and full of music and art. One of those people is here with us tonight, and this show tonight is being dedicated to Dr. Ruth Greenfield. Dr. Greenfield, although she is a native of Key West, has lived for many, many, many decades here in Miami, and she is truly, truly, truly a pillar of this community of arts. She started, look around you here in the Arsh tonight. Dr. Ruth Greenfield started the very first music conservatory in Miami-Dade County that accepted all children, no matter where they were, what nationality, what color, the very, very first conservatory to do that. She then went on to say downtown Miami, downtown where we are right now, is so important. But we've got to make downtown important with music as well. And she started the very first, out in the public, on the steps of Miami-Dade County, the lunchtime music series, which brought really famous musicians from all over the place. Just sit onto the steps, bring your lunch, and sit out in the Miami sunshine. But really, really top artists for all of us. Then, one of the things that we really do appreciate and honor the most is that with Loretta Dranoff, who started the Dranoff Foundation, with her, for in memory of her husband, Murray, Dr. Ruth Greenfield was one of the founders of the Dranoff Foundation. And then, what brings us all together tonight at Piano Slam is that connection, that rhythm, that feeling that we have between the connection of music and poetry. And Dr. Greenfield has been part of the oldest poetry group in Miami-Dade County called Boaz, and has been an inspiration to this entire program tonight. So on behalf of not just Dranoff, but of all the young people who have participated in Piano Slam this year and for 11 years before, please welcome and help me thank Dr. Ruth Greenfield, who's here with us tonight. Thank you all. So, talking about pillars, I think that we all need to look around and see who we are and what we are in this community right here at the Arsht. And I just want to tell you, as I try and tell every single arts performance I am, that Miami-Dade County has brought the foundation to the arts community through cultural affairs, through art in public places, through all kinds of programming. And really, Miami-Dade County was the organization that helped start the Dranoff Foundation. And tonight, we're very honored to have here, to welcome us all to this wonderful Adrian Arsh Center. I'd like to bring and ask you to welcome to the stage our mayor, the Honorable Carlos Jimenez. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you so much. Thank you for that kind introduction. And for me, it's a pleasure to be here for Piano Slam 11. You know, over 80,000 of our students, our brightest and our best, have participated in this competition. And tonight, I think everybody in the audience, you're in for a real treat. This is, I think, is my third or fourth one, and so I'm looking forward to it. Looking forward to hearing and looking at the presentations and the performances. And I know that this is one of my favorite nights. My wife is back there, and we come every year. So I one of the things that I do as mayor is one of the neat things I do is I get to proclaim stuff. So tonight I'm not going to read the whole proclamation, but I want to end it by saying, well, I'll read some of it. Historically, Miami-Dade County has been known to embrace the rich cultural diversities and contributions made by individuals, organizations, and institutions that have added to our varied heritage and enhanced our quality of life. And whereas Piano Slam 11, a classical hip-hop spoken word extravaganza, features our community's youngest top poets with internationally acclaimed classical pianists Stephanie Ho and Sara Ahuvia and DJ Cardi, celebrating the music of Beethoven, Stravinsky, and Copland, along with Beyonce and Drake, while dancing to the choreography of Augusto Soledad and Brass Dance to create a one-of-a-kind event. And so we're in for a big treat. Now, therefore, be resolved that I, Carlos Jimenez, Mayor of Miami-Dade County, Chairwoman Audrey M. Edmondson, and the members of the Board of County Commissioners, on behalf of Miami-Dade County and this community, do hereby proclaim Thursday, February 28th, 2019, as Piano Slam 11, Dranoff 2, Piano Foundation Day. Congratulations to both of you. There is the photographer. There.
Thank you. No.
You're on.
I'm on. All right. Thank you so much, Mayor. All the cultural support you've been giving to the community has been incredible. And I think when we sit back in a couple minutes and watch this performance, we really realize what the value and the power of the arts are to create a vibrant community. So thank you very much.
It's certainly my pleasure. And Miami-Dade County has invested a lot in culture, does so every year. You're actually sitting in this great concert hall and the opera house across the way. They cost us money well spent, close to $500 million. And so we did invest, and we do invest a lot in culture because the return on investment is unbelievable, not only in dollars, but actually enriching the community. And the reason why this community and why this Miami in general is becoming a world-class city is because of our culture and the rise of culture in our community. And you will always have a supporter in myself and my wife, and I know in the Board of County Commissioners. And so again, for us, it's a pleasure to be here. Congratulations on your proclamation. And to everybody in the audience, have a great night. I know you're going to have a great night. Thank you. God bless
you
all.
Thank you so much, the Honorable Mayor Carlos Jimenez. Are you ready? Are you ready? Piano Slam 11!
Money.
carried us from our seclusion. She protected us like a mother. Yemaya, the living ocean, her warm, calm winds like harmonious notes, my heart rising with the rhythm of Elidolele and Okonkolo. Just for her, as she safely carried us to our new home, Miami, she said, live for me. To you, my mother, La Mas Bella, the most beautiful one, in your calming waters, me di un baño, and you, the most poised ocean, cleanse my sin. You who gave sight to me when I promised you my life. Mi Maya, gracias por esta tierra. When I landed on her shores, she welcomed us with open arms. Miami has treated me as a mother should, enfolding us in stars and pearls that glisten in the moonlight, offering the bargain of freedom for the price of leaving home. Loud voices in a cacophony of quarter notes waft through the air as old men sipping their coladas reminisce about a Cuba they once knew. The sound of distant drums calling from the homeland, begging us to return to her shores once more, beating to the rhythm of our hearts. The voices of exile, screaming soprano notes that crescendo across the waves and over the ocean. El grito de mi alma, anchored in the roots of my people, my people. Chains rattle and fall away, but our unyielding spirits are reborn, initiated into the religion of freedom, playing our instruments in the symphony of Miami. She carried us from our oppression. She protected us like a mother. Yemaya, the living ocean, delivered us safely to Miami as if she knew I would be perfect here. She said, live for me, Asuga! Yachebadi!
Have you ever compared sailing with the journey to your goals? Everything starts as a tranquil day. You're in your boat, sailing. As time goes on, waves start going in a crescendo mode, as if everything gave a 360-degree turn. That's how it goes. The calm melody of the wind disappears. The only thing you can listen to is thunder, raindrops, and your despair. You're moving up and down like the notes of a song. But nothing lasts forever. And like people say, after the storm comes the calm. The tempo of the waves starts slowing down, and the melody of the wind is again a beautiful sound. The only problem is that now you're lost in the middle of the ocean. You don't know where you came from or where you're going. All you can see is H2O, and at the distance, all these people reaching their coast. But the point is not to get to another person's coast. The point is to get to your home, your city, your coast. And you keep sailing aimlessly until you find your way again, finally. Then you reach that soul-desired coast and realize that is not the place you belong to. You belong to the ocean. Discovering and making new journeys, that's what you're made for. Even though there are a bunch of storms out there, now you know you're brave. You know you can face those ups and downs and get to a new accomplishment. So you go on and make a new journey to an undefined place. Yes, you, the ocean, and your boat. And all that journey through the ocean is the journey to your goals.
Wondered how it would feel to be in the middle of the ocean. Would the water embrace me like a couple on the dance floor, a bachata atop the surface of the sea? Would it be as bipolar as the Miami weather, cold one moment, so warm the next? Would I still be able to see the halo of Sobe's neon glow? Would the booming music reach me in the middle of the ocean? Seaweed tickling the bottoms of my feet, my hair riding the waves like starlight? Would I still be able to see the fish chill past me? Could I swim with the dolphins, welcomed into the Guajira, moving in sync, rhythmic, tribal, connected to a destination unknown, but beautiful nonetheless? Forgive a Bronx girl for questioning, having so many questions. Once my boyfriend and I carved our anniversary into the sand while singing along to a bouncing music behind us. Porque eres mi santa y solamente creo en Dios y en ti, mi amor. The waves tickling the shore and the wind whistling through the palm trees were music made naturally. And my spirit sang. A smile surprises my face as I exhale. I am at peace, my body at ease. I know my answers. I float.
Vendors are in the pit orchestra, warming up their instruments while the dancers are at the crosswalk putting on their powder pink point shoes. The cement stings the soles of their feet, but they take their stand as the spotlight turns to them. The chanting from the locals on Calle Ocho are deafening. They scream, Miami, I love you. Miami, I love you. Their accents mixing with the hum of the city, making a song just for their promised sanctuary floating in the sea. The bellowing of a cruise ship coming in starts the music. Miami has been blessed by the ocean, but still been dealt a bad hand by being the hotspot destination for natural devastation. Still, the city's forever painted in the colors of the sunset, no matter what time of day it is. It's a part of Florida, but identifies as a million different nationalities. The colors of the flags coat the shoreline. However, the people that work in the city don't even live in Miami. Here, the city pretties herself up for the tourists, but makes the natives hide under the highways and in between the alleyways. Still, the sound of rapid Spanish stops whenever the music plays.
The Wise. Dave Chappelle once said, every black American is bilingual. All of us. We speak street vernacular. And we speak job interview. I'm black and bilingual. A duet of dialect dancing on my tongue. One, to socialize. One, to survive. A code-switching chameleon, changing colors depending on the color I'm interacting with. I change cultures, like how I change clothes, my wardrobe. Depends on the world I'm submerged in when I'm in an ebony environment, in the company of people whose melanin sits unapologetically on their skin. I speak my native language of Ebonics with rhythm my ancestors passed down to me. I speak the language of rappers spinning bars on the radio, a black man talking sports in the barbershop, a black woman sharing gossip with a side of tea at the church service, of slaves serenading each other in the field to make life more bearable. My accent has a musical punch carrying traces of the tunes of Haiti. My colorful Caribbean voice, imperfect and informal, but no imitation. This is my most organic voice, the one I used to open up behind closed doors in another world where I'm the yin and everybody else is the yang. They are the lights. I am the darkness. I change the tune of my tone. I speak polite, I speak right, or as the black individual likes to say, I speak white. I feel like a black sheep in white sheep's clothing, a world-class actor. I put the art in artificial and articulate. I speak the language of one percenters, of those who've never felt the fear of being hunted, a privilege passed down from generation to generation. The bass in my voice, it's gone. To make sure they can't label me aggressive, I erase my Ebonics, silence the melanin in my voice, mute my natural melody, all because of the hate you give. The third world lives inside of me, a conflicted world full of identities in crisis. There's a solution, silence. these songs of stereotypes. Listen to my most important voice, the one that sings in my head, telling me to be myself. I will not whitewash my instrument for you. I will be comfortable in the skin I was born in and waltz into any room and be who I am, a conductor, harmonize with my blackness.
The thunder and lightning clapping like cymbals over the glittering clear sea. It feels like nobody has to be. All of the people watching from small screens, just like hearing part of a chord that goes do, re, mi, is just like a prelude to something much worse. All we do now is look at the technology with our phones, iPads, laptops. It occurred to me several times in rhythmic timing, as if I was a metronome playing equal-timed beats. You don't have to be there to see what you want to see. You can experience life's casualties from the palm of your hand. Listen to the sound energy when it crescendos, just as waves ripple against the shore. All of these thoughts rushing to my mind in a symphony of beeping. Beeping, clicking, ticking in an ostinato. The trill of beeping coming from where? None other than those who were supposed to be, the next generation. Like the code at the end of sheet music. But now the technology is ruining, going from one person to the other, like notes being individually played in a melody. Beeping, keeping the tempo even when it changes key. Clicking, hearing your friend texting rhythmically. Ticking, like the clock at your bedside playing a jig to wake you up. Does it really take this much to separate a human from a piece of man-made technology? YouTube, Instagram, like the beginning of an anthem singing. Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, you hear the bells ringing. All of this well-known media bringing humans into the future, but still there's something missing. Unknown of these places is that they can be similar to a rhapsody. They can be a rhapsody of sharing, such as getting vibratos of text from a longtime friend. A rhapsody of connection, such as discovering you had a family member you never got to know. But yet this beautiful and melodic rhapsody can turn into a rhapsody of monstrosity.
I exist in three worlds, spinning at different tempos, spinning so out of orbit that the tides of my oceans no longer create a lulling tune. Miami, my first world, my home, where the harmony of bells signify just how much more liquor stores there are than libraries still. I welcome the crescendo of squealing tires on the asphalt, as the boys in my neighborhood perform donuts on back streets. Florida, my second world, a place I still welcome but cannot call home. Venturing into certain neighborhoods is where I hear the rhythm of dial tones reporting my suspicious presence. The harmony of their voices as they repeat into the phone, "No officer, I don't think she's supposed to be in this area." America, my third world, separated by social status, in which the tonalities of each are no longer in center with my given key. I am my own minstrel, but my solo has a constant interlude created by static, coming from the officer's radio as he side-eyes my blackness while reaching to ensure that his weapon is still there. The cries of the people have become the new national anthem. An echoing shot is now the coda. I'm not resisting is the hymn we've all seemed to master in unity. The intervals between our deaths no longer have a count. Black notes rest on black bodies that now lay on the black ground. Both erase their musical timesheets before their melodies could be complete. Beaten bodies reach out their last notes, putting them into a whole rest, diminishing their tune so we call them deadbeats. This is my playlist, a never-ending cycle of faltering notes. Peace inside my mind has been warped into a peninsula, cornered by each of these worlds as they spew out their serenades, each trying to create a ballad that will make them more in tune with the others. My three worlds, my three orchestras, my ensembles, they have no harmony. My tunes, they have no central tempo. My holy trinity, a choir plagued by sin.
Individuality, my struggle. Trying to survive without panic. Sharing my identity with my other half, my twin. Trying to be me when I'm always linked, like a duet, my partner is always there. Trying to be and not be. Seeing my face reflected on another. Marching to a tune that is like another. In the oceans of my thoughts, I want to live my own experiences. Hearing my mother's voice, you are two peas in a pod. I want to be me, but I struggle. I want to be a soloist, but my music is a duet. My struggle remains, but I come to a realization. I see the beauty of my predicament like a Miami sunrise. My brother is always there, making my days less lonely and doubling my rhythmic skill.
Thank you. Perhaps it's strange that I wasn't raised on bachata or reggaeton or know the lyrics to songs talking about el malecón going dry. At least, I think it's strange. In my city, the culture is built on the Latin slang coming out of the mouths of the aliens and their children. Their music was as colorful as their skin tones, listening to all the different rappers and singers that compose our childhood memories, but I never knew how to follow that beat. While other children enjoyed music they liked, the sound of church choirs was shoved in my ears and down my throat until all that came out of my mouth were lyrics involving the Heavenly Father and His kingdom. Amen. Perhaps what they say about the devil is true, that he comes in the form of temptation. And at the age of 10, I was made Eve, and the apple was presented to me in the form of generic pop songs and guilty pleasures. Perhaps it was silly to feel so guilty. I had never known anything but soundtracks and overplayed radio hits, yet my tongue spoke familiar lyrics to friends that never knew about my lack of freedom to listen. My blood continued flowing to the holy gospel, stubborn like the current of a river, forcing me on my knees to ask for mercy and forgiveness until my throat was raw from serenading God with my screams and tears dropping in harmony. I'm not quite sure if my ears have stopped ringing. Perhaps my ears will never recover, but now my veins are tuned. I no longer lie to friends with guitar solos. Instead, they hear the harshness that composes my own voice. I no longer view my family as the ones who made me tone deaf to the world. Rather, their actions have made my hearing sharper, despite the ringing that will never leave. I no longer serenade God with my misery, though some days He hears those songs of mine. And though my lips continue speaking psalms, know this, the lyrics cannot reach the heavens now that they're no longer heavy on my tongue.
Expanse of structures stretching beyond the eye reaches to see. A whirlwind of cultures together in harmonic chaos, interacting, growing, flourishing alongside one another. alive in the air of freedom, lost in the bursting swirls of color, of greens and blues and a million shades, never discovered. The clash of three worlds raging in my soul, the music in my life, its argument lying in a song, pleading against the world in my stead. The reality around me mercilessly bearing on my dreams, my hope, and then there is something else. The art, the breeze of life and poetry rustling through my hair, the stories of old and new pumping my blood. An endless symphony, the honking cars in perfect allegro, the flying shutter serving for andante, joined by the eternal pulse of pattering feet on pavement. Never once silent and never once gone, joined by the eternal pulse of sharp waves slapping against the smooth shore. Wild, untamed. Untamed but restrained by the sandy shore, its waves shifting the sand beneath your feet in a steady pulse of the ocean's breathing. 1,000 mysteries confined to the sea.
Thank you. Watching the oscillations of the waves, under the savage staccato of the rain, I watch my future get snatched away. Miami, covered by the tide. No more music on Ocean Drive, only destruction survives. I remember when the ocean was beautiful, its bounty plentiful, but no one served as its conductor to keep its instruments in time, no one to keep it in pitch, no protection of its beautiful melody, only our own disruptions of its elegant harmony. But still, it was nature's gift that kept on giving, the flower that kept on blooming, the band that kept on playing its beautiful music. The drift of the waves was calm. I would just sit out under the palms, just gaze and appreciate. But deep down inside, I knew it was hurting. I knew it would depreciate. The dynamic was growing. Every day a crescendo. The big blue was no longer singing the slow blues, but a furious rock and roll of anger and pain. Now, I hear the thunder in the dry sky. I can see the possibilities for my home waning, the ocean's violent goodbye. Man-built, hand-built civilization draining, the waves crashing in Fortissimo, the destruction in Acelerando, the ocean covering the buildings in a swift glissando. But then I watch the waves diminuendo. I hear the adagio of the crashes. I see the sun dissipate the clouds as if the ocean was taking a bow before its catastrophic encore.
Scores of trash lining the sand, an obvious environmental hazard along the shore.
It's really sad because I'm walking along the beach and it's completely littered.
Littered.
Together, us humans and other competitors, as the sun remains in the center, like an ensemble, the plants begin their plans, the minstrels remain on Miami's lands. Team spirit begins to feel less incoherent. As we breathe, we let it free. The carbon dioxide that's now in Miami, but the plants, on the contrary, make use of the carbon we don't need. Humble and not greedy, serving as an interlude of gratitude, creating a duet of harmony. The friendly neighborhood sun, doing its dynamic jig, providing energy for the lads and chicks. The plants taking it in quick. Team spirit in the mix. The ocean evaporates for our sake. The last coda awaits. A structure of clouds form, ready to create a storm. Precipitation falls in determination. Another specific note, the plants receiving H2O. While the ingredients in the plants flow, team spirit is in the down low. The plants finally finish their recipe after their long, pleasant journey. Letting out oxygen of enthusiasm, the human's intake. The cycle complete, ready to repeat. Team spirit no longer obsolete.
Self-destruction, there was
A flooding emergency along coastal cities today in South Florida as rising tides are leading to flooded streets.
Another night of tidal flooding on Miami.
Florida reportedly has the most number of big cities at risk from rising sea level.
Scientific models predict most of Miami Beach could be underwater by the end of the century.
Placido as white doves, yet the ground fights like two siblings exchanging blows over the remote on a Saturday morning. In the blink of an eye, everything shifts from Andante and starts to accelerando. Tectonic plates approach each other as if they were sworn enemies, while in the midst, fault lines stray and jams. And over a grand amount of time, the pressure grows like a crescendo in these fault lines, becoming so powerful. Boom, bang, blast. Disregarding everyone in their past, they clash. All because of built-up aggression. Built-up aggression, a crescendo in ourselves. Built-up aggression, a crescendo in our world. Traffic lights and tall buildings tumble, trees forcefully dance, homes and restaurants cave in like a decrescendo, and people panic. Hearts are filled with terror and fear with one question in mind. When will this reach its finale? In a few minutes. In a few minutes, it'll be over and reach the double bar lines, but it won't be forgotten. It'll be highlighted in news headlines and in hearts. Physical and chemical changes will have interluded. Houses, roads, schools, and street lights will be able to go back to their original states, but the injured, deceased, and people who will now live with PTSD will never be the same. All because of built-up aggression. Built-up aggression, a crescendo in ourselves, built-up aggression, a crescendo in our world. Haiti, Japan, Chile, and many more were victims. Man-made structures and God-given objects no longer serenade. Their once stable grounds repercussed over thousands of casualties and billions of dollars for repairs. The hymn that was in place is now nothing but a catastrophe. Something about built-up aggression is that you never know when the eruption will take place. Many of us take blows back to back, yet we remain piano. Like fault lines, we shove and jam all the hostility and violence deep down inside until we just can't take anymore, till we explode at least like the intro of a fanfare. Some different than others. Some pray, some cry, some confront, and some erupt. Like Nicholas Cruz, Adam Lanza, and Jesse Osborne. Boom. Bang, blast. Disregarding everyone in their past, they fired. Without an inch of empathy, a chemical reaction had taken place. The warm bodies of teachers, students, and administrators were now cold and lifeless, permanently rearranging the ions and molecules that made them the person they once were. All because of built-up aggression. Built-up aggression, a crescendo in ourselves. Built-up aggression, a crescendo in our world. Built-up aggression. Finally, when the decrescendo takes place, the aftermath will be a fermata, built up aggression.
Hostage, wild lashes like Miami palm leaves thrashing against my wrenched, animalist eyes. Three souls of doubt gripping to my intestines, the emerald molecules tracing my prismatic skin. The dulcet of my heart pumping the chords to my symphony. Blank faces, dull eyes mocking me, capricious mangoes in their acidic tongues. Three spirited hands, their silky skin, claiming their leverage within my veins. Sinful intentions, they release their witchcraft with the ensemble winds, angiosperms moribund. Wild waves wax the gold sand grains, milkweed buoyant upon them.
Thank you. Sometimes I rest for a bar and think about my pain. When I do the right thing, they put dirt on my name. Feel like a caged animal that can't be tamed. I ain't doing it for the clout, never heard of fame. Paint a picture with my lyrics, I should call it Wynwood. They called me a lame, never understood. I'm an outcast, but they echo my rhythm. They called me the monster, but I'm the victim. I'm a leader, you're a sponge. About to pop off like a cap off a soldier. Always come clutch, I'm getting bolder. In the zoo, I'm really a soldier. Man of my word, I ain't no poser. Not they mad, they throwing a shoulder. Mocking my movement, just like a mirror. To the game, shot Miami Heat, I figure. Pray on my downfall, but I'm a winner. I'm a brio, you're a puppet to my sauce. Got me a bucket, what you got? Go get something. From Miami, I ain't talking about the zoo. I'm on the field like I play for the U. My flow colder than an iced out pool. 305, yeah, you know what it do. At Bayside, riding on our sweet rides. At Miami Beach, only keep good vibes. In the Florida heat, living my best life.
Dying too. But what will these creatures do to survive? They'll kill, fight, hunt, but in the end, they're all human, right? These creatures are dying every day, especially the ones we call black. Mammals like us, dying. Everywhere. We try to act all hard because of our color, but truly it's getting us killed. And we try to act like these high tides don't bother us. However, is this a true way of life? An ocean full of life, survival, love.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, the company of Piano Slam 11!
My name is Renata Tehillan, and I go to Hartsfield Middle!
My name is Zaire Stevens, and I'm from Myrtle Grove, K-8.
My name is Brenda Gonzalez, and I go to Miami Air Charter School.
I'm Jessica Goldskin, and I'm from Northern.
I'm Jack O'Meara, and I'm from Leader City.
I'm Christopher Badillo, and I go to School for Advanced Studies South.
I'm Isabel Papp. I go to Miami Arts Charter School.
I'm Michelle Espinosa, and I go to Carl Gamble Senior High.
I'm Alex Cabrera, and I go to Pasadena Middle School.
I'm Alicia Wellison, and I go to Miami.
I'm Clarissa Pengzal, and I go to Pasadena Middle School.
I'm Jonathan Fresno, and I represent Miami Arts Senior High.
I'm Jessica Contreras from Miami Arts Charter Homestead.
I'm Cassandra Water, I go to Homestead Senior High.
I'm Rosanna Hernandez, and I go to Richmond Heights Middle School.
I'm Jose Brancho, and I'm from Hialeah High.
Miami, make some noise for presidents. The man behind the moves, the movement, the magic tonight. The Brass Dance choreographer, Augusto Soledad. Let's hear it for Amanda Kreider. Our pianist, Stephanie Ansar. And I'm your DJ, DJ Carter. And help me welcome to the stage, Executive Director of the Drain Off 2 Piano Foundation, Carlene Sawyer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the artists of Piano Slam 11. Woo! What a night. What a beautiful night. Think about this. Every single thing that you heard tonight came from the music. The music in their hearts, the music of these artists. There's one artist here that we have to mention, the music, and that is the composer of tonight's classical jazz theme, and that's Mr. Martin Bejarano right here from Miami. So give it up for Martin. Thousands and thousands and thousands of Miami-Dade Public Schools teenagers wrote about what music meant to them. And as music comes up and you have a show in a wonderful auditorium, a wonderful showcase like this, every show like this, every music, every great performance needs a fantastic maestra. And this year, we are so thrilled, right from Broadway, please, please give it up for our director, Alana Ransom Tablets. I just want to thank you all for being here. Think about this, all these young people from Homestead, Miami Gardens, Hialeah, the beaches, all right here with our great partner, the Adrian Arsh Center for the Performing Arts. And I'm so thrilled to be here because this is our 11th year, but this is our first year we get to work with the new CEO here. And I'd like to thank so much Mr. Johann Zietzman for having us here in this beautiful hall tonight. You know, the education for these young people goes from music to language to science. And we do that in great concert with the Miami-Dade Public Schools. I'd like to thank our superintendent, Alberto Carvalho, and in particular, I really, really, really want to thank people that made this happen at the district. And those people are Lori Kaplan, Mr. Christopher Carranza, and Patricio Suarez, all of you, I just thank you so much. You know, when the district came and said, we really want this wonderful music creative writing program to include science, we really had no idea what we could do with this. So we looked at the language, we explored it, and you've seen what the students did tonight. But this is our hometown, this is Miami, and we have the greatest research center in all of the world on what's happening with our marine life, what's happening with our ocean currents, what's happening with our atmosphere, and that's the University of Miami Rosenstiel School of Marine and Atmospheric Science. And I would like to thank the CARTH Project at Rasmus, because every single curriculum, every field trip out to see our world and our through the ocean's eyes has been put into place by a partnership with Dr. Tamai Asgachman and Laura Bracken. So thank you so much. Thank you. Tonight you've seen just, you know, different views of the world through music, and you see all around you this horrible garbage and plastic, and that's one of the things that the CARTH project is studying. But you know, as we listen to this and we look at what is our outlook, what is our future, what have you heard from our students, I have to tell you what a sense of personal responsibility that they've learned for their future and the way they've expressed it. But I also have to thank one more time our mayor, Carlos Jimenez, for making Miami-Dade County the only actual county that's one of the 100 resilient cities, looking forward to how we can have a better environmental future. So would you please thank one more time Mayor Jimenez. This is like, I know, it's almost like some horribly long, I know I'm going to get played off soon, but it's about music. You see these two Steinway grand pianos, these two gorgeous pianos that Stephanie and Sar, these are Steinway pianos, and Steinway has been our partner, well, Dranoff's partner for over 50 years, but every single year into Title I schools, Steinway brings these beautiful pianos so that no matter where our students are, whether they're in, you know, one high school, one middle school, whether they're, you know, north, south, east, or west, that they can be part of a really professional community. And we couldn't do that without Steinway. Also, we have a new sponsor tonight, and that is a wonderful, wonderful shared ride company called Hovit, H-O-V-I-T. Howard Allman, Miami family, my parents knew his parents, has started this new company, and they have gotten our families around, all of us around, and we want to thank them so much, because we wouldn't be here on the stage tonight without them. So why are we really here? We were really here because we wanted to hear the music. We were really here because we wanted to see what kind of great dancing was happening. But we were here to hear the poetry. A poetry competition based on music in young people's lives. That's what Piano Slam is. And I have to tell you, one of our partners throughout all this time, one of my favorite partners, because what they've taught us about commitment, about winning, about role model, about vision, and they've really brought that both to Piano Slam and to these young people's lives as role models. I want to tell you, we're going to talk about the winners, but before we do, can we give it up for our winningest Miami Heat? They've just been fantastic, and they have taught these young people how much work and dedication it is. So, that's the competition. So now we want to hear the winners. So tonight, from all county, across the entire county, I'm going to announce now, number one in the county for middle school English, from Myrtle Grove, K through 8, Mr. Zaire Stevens! Wow, Myrtle Grove, this is your first year, great time. Number one in Miami-Dade County for middle school science, from Ponce de Leon Middle School, Kyra Beckpan-Gensel! These young people deserve every single bit of your applause. So now get ready. Get ready for the earthquake. From Miami, Norland, in science, Jessica Golden! But absolutely not least, number one, all county high school English from Miami Norland, Jonathan Brooks-Wong! Just one more thing. Get ready for Piano Slam 12!